What are you so nervous about?
Don't you know who's coming today?
Yeah, Dusty Baker. What's so special about that?
What's so special? He's my idol.
So what? That's nothing to worry about. He's human, just like the rest of us.
I know, but
come on. I had a great time with Gary Carter, and Tom Seaver was really nice to Rick. In fact, I think the only one of us who hadn't gotten along with his idol was the chicken, and that's because he doesn't have one.
Uh-oh, there he is.
So go say hello.
Well, okay.
You got Brock and Marshall. You're going to have a whole new ball club. Dusty, I want to introduce you to your number one fan. This is Zach. Zach Dusty Baker.
Nice to meet you, Zach.
Nice to meet you.
Zach, you sure picked a fine player to be your idol.
In his 11th season with both the Atlanta Braves and the Los Angeles Dodgers, Dusty Baker has firmly established himself as one of the finest outfielders in the game today. But that's really no surprise, especially to former Brave teammate Hank Aaron, who once said that Baker had more potential than any outfielder he'd ever seen in all his seasons with the Braves. Despite that glowing praise, the Braves sent Baker to the Dodgers in 1976, where he's patrolled left field ever since. In 1977, Dusty hit a career-high 30 home runs, and along with Steve Garvey, Ron Say, and Reggie Smith, became part of the first foursome to hit 30 or more homers for one club in a single season. Then in 1981, Dusty realized three lifelong dreams as he made the All-Star team, won a gold glove, and became a world champion as his Dodgers defeated the New York Yankees in six games.
You make it look so easy. I can't believe you're really here.
You may not believe this, Zach, but I know exactly how you feel. I remember the first time I met my idol, too.
You had an idol, too?
Yes, I did. Tommy Davis used to play with the Los Angeles Dodgers. When I was a kid, he was my idol, and he had number 12. And when I got traded from the Atlanta Braves to the Los Angeles Dodgers, they gave me number 12, too.
Wow, that's neat. Now you can take me to the outfield and show me how to make those diving catches.
Wait a minute, Zach. Let Dusty meet the rest of the bunch first, too, huh? All right. Hey, bud. I want you to meet Dusty Baker of the Los Angeles Dodgers.
How you doing?
Chicken, what are you doing?
I think it has something to do with him not having an idol.
You can't just pick an idol like that, Chicken. I'd love to be your idol, but choose carefully and think about it. An idol has to be someone who you respect and admire and someone who does the kind of things you like to do.
Johnny, what's this all about?
I think I understand this egghead after working with his scrambled mind for so long. This jive turkey digs your high five.
The Dodgers do that a lot. They must really like each other.
As a matter of fact, we do. Most of the players on the Dodgers are really good friends.
Chicken, we don't have time for all this stuff.
Yeah, Dusty and I have to get to the outfield so he can show me how to make those great catches.
Wait a minute, Zach. Don't you guys loosen up before you play?
Well, we like to throw the ball around.
Have you ever heard of Pepper?
Sure, but that's just a game. We're serious when we warm up.
Pepper may be a game, but it's a good way to warm up.
Dusty's right.
Pepper has long been an accepted part of baseball tradition. In fact, as early as the 30s, teams used Pepper to warm up before games. Today, Pepper is still around, and so are several offshoots, including Flip, a game made famous by the Milwaukee Brewers.
Major leaguers can play Pepper, you can too.
Would you show us how?
Sure, but why don't we split up into two groups? It's a lot easier that way. Four go with Johnny, and five stay here with me.
All right, I'll take Andy and Sherman and Debbie and Rick. All right,
let's go.
All right.
All right, well, I think we have the best bunch here.
Yeah.
Most important thing about playing pepper is not to fool around when you're playing. The ball moves around very fast. If you're not paying attention, somebody could get hurt.
How do you tell who wins?
Well, pepper's not a game for winning or losing. It's a game for developing skills like hand and eye coordination for the fielders, and if you're a batter, get used to seeing the ball hit the bat, something that's very important in hitting. So let's get started.
All right, come on, let's have a little pepper. Here we go. Right here. There we go. That way, Debbie. Good play now. A little timing coordination is good for the hitter, too. Good fielding practice. That way, Sherman. That way. Come on, Deb. Good play.
Bam. And Lewis. Oh, excellent, Michelle. Great. Zach. Good, Sam. Chicken. Sam. And Lewis.
No errors so far. You guys have been practicing, haven't you? Uh-huh. Motion. There we go. That's the way. Smooth. Go down to the ball, pick it up. Oh, a little spin. Oh, a little style there, huh, Sharon? Been reading that book on style again? Uh-oh. Breaking ball. I saw it. That okay?
Good play.
There's Sherman.
Stop it, Chicken.
Yeah, Chick.
Good catch, Louie. I don't say you caught that one, Louie, with the chicken in the way. Chicken, pepper's not a game of win or lose. Pepper's a game to develop your skills. You gotta give everybody a chance. You're a bird, not a hog. Well, I guess I'm not his idol anymore.
Well, you're still mine, Dusty, so let's wrap up this warm-up and get to the outfield.
Hey, Chicken, what are you doing? Looking for a new idol? Come on, let me see. Oh, Chicken, stop sulking. Let me see it. I'm not interested anyway. I'd rather watch Dusty teach us about playing the outfield.
And you just have to come up throwing.
Sorry I'm late. I was just trying to convince the Chicken to join us.
You know, I think I might have been a little bit too hard on Chicken before.
Don't worry about him. He hates to be left out of anything. He'll be back.
All right, then, let's get going again. Now, Zach, one of the hardest plays to make in baseball is to charge a ground ball and throw on the run.
How come?
Well, because there are a lot of things to think about in a short period of time to think about doing them.
Especially if the base runner's on his way home.
Thank you.
Wow, Dusty, do you think I could do that?
Sure, all it takes is a lot of practice.
You think so?
Of course, but I think we'll need someone to help us out. Got anybody in mind, Johnny?
Hey, Chicken, put that book down and come on over here.
I think the only one of us who hasn't gotten along with his idol was the chicken, and that's because he doesn't have one.
I don't know what's wrong with that chicken.
Hey, Rick, see if you can get that chicken up and moving, will you?
Okay, Johnny.
Picking up a ground ball on the run and throwing a runner out requires more than just a good arm. An outfielder must always know the situation before he can decide what he has to do, like the inning or the number of outs, the speed of the base runner. Do I have to hurry or do I have time? Do I throw home to get the runner or to second to keep the batter out of scoring position?
Dusty, why don't we try one?
Let's do it.
Rick, forget the chicken. Get a bat and hit some out here.
If I can't get the runner at home, I get down on one knee and make the safe play to second base.
Hit it, Rick.
But if I decide to throw home, the first thing I do is to maintain my speed. Then I come up throwing. Watch me. Rick, hit me another one. You ready to try it?
Sure.
I think we need a base runner. Let's see if the chicken's feathers are unruffled. Chicken, are you ready to play yet?
Chicken, I'm sorry about before.
Okay, Chicken, you be the base runner at second. Sam, you be the catcher.
Okay, Zach, here we go. It's the bottom of the ninth, two out, man on second, your team's winning 3-1. Okay, hit it, Rick. Trying to do there?
Throw the chicken out at the plate.
Why?
Because I didn't want him to score.
But you were winning by 2 runs. Getting the chicken at the plate wasn't as important as keeping Rick off a second where he could tie the game with a single.
But if I had got him out, the game would have been over.
But you didn't, and you can't afford to take the chance and put the tying run in scoring position.
I see what you mean.
Okay, now you've got a man on second base, still 2 outs, and the score is now 3-2. And Rick's up. Think about what you want to do with the ball in this situation. Okay, Rick.
All right, Zach, nice throw. That's a way to do it.
Good thinking, Zach. In that situation, you had to throw home because that was a tying run. Zach, before we go, I have a surprise for you.
All right, Dusty Baker, that's neat, yeah.
Thanks a million, Dusty. It was sure fun playing the outfield with you today.
Thank you. I had a good time. And here, Chicken, this is for you.
Come on. All right, nothing up your sleeve. And... oh, no. Goose Gossie's nuts.
How do you like that?
He finally found an idol.
Johnny, did you have an idol?
Of course I did.
Better was a catcher.
Well, not really. Believe it or not, my idol was a fleet-footed outfielder, the greatest player ever to come out of my home state of Oklahoma, Mickey Mantle.
I've heard of him. My dad says he's one of the best outfielders ever.
That's true. In his 18 years in the major leagues, Mickey Mantle hit 536 home runs. But even more impressively, he still holds the records for most home runs, most RBIs, and most runs scored in World Series history. He also won the American League's Triple Crown in 1956 and was voted most valuable player three times before he finally wound up in the Hall of Fame.
Wow!
But I think that Johnny will tell you that there were other outfielders with credentials just as impressive.
That's right, Sherm. Over the years, some of the most recognizable names in baseball have come from the outfield. Names like Babe Ruth of the New York Yankees, whose impact on baseball was enormous. In a decade known as the Roaring Twenties, many of the Babe's exploits became legendary. Most notably, his 714 home runs. A few years after Ruth, Joe DiMaggio came to the Yankees, and in 1941, he hit in 56 straight games, a record that still stands today and might stand forever. While DiMaggio was swinging away in the American League, Stan Musial was swinging away in the National League. Known simply as the man, Musial finished his St. Louis Cardinal career with a .331 average and won a total of 7 batting titles. Still in the 50s, Musial shared much of the National League spotlight with Willie Mays, who some consider the greatest ball player ever to put on a pair of spikes. In 22 seasons with the Giants and Mets, Mays was always considered one of the game's most feared hitters and finished third on the all-time home run list with 660. The number one home run hitter of all time is, of course, Henry Aaron, who broke Babe Ruth's record of 714 on April 8, 1974. Until Aaron came along, Ruth's record was thought to be unreachable, but then nobody ever had the reflexes or the wrist strength Aaron possessed. Aaron was also an outstanding fielder and the perfect team man. A quiet, dignified, and respected gentleman throughout his career with the Braves and Brewers, Henry Aaron just might have been the best outfielder baseball has ever seen. Now, all these players were known for their hitting, but they also were outstanding defensive outfielders. And the one thing that made them so good in the field was that they always knew the situation. Uh-oh, I think I've stirred up that stimulating strategist with a sterling silver tongue.
Yes, you have, Mr. Bench. I can't tell you how many times I've seen a player make a crucial error that cost his team a run or even a game because he didn't know the situation. So before each pitch, decide what you're going to do with the ball if it's hit to you. In fact, you should expect every ball to come your way. And if you know the situation, you won't make the crucial initial error. So my words for today are, know the situation.
All right, once again, pearls of precious pontification from that prince of ponderous prose. All right, let's go over what we learned today. All right, Dusty taught us how to play pepper, and that taught us how to get our arm and reflexes sharp. He also taught us how to charge a ball and come up throwing. And Dusty and the Wizard, who spent a lot of time together, both taught us how important it is to know the situation. Chicken, did you learn anything today? We learned about idols.
Johnny, you're my idol.
Oh, flattery will get you everywhere, Michelle.
But where's my T-shirt?
I don't know about a T-shirt, but I'll let you be first in batting practice today. Let's go. Join us next time for more fun and games right here on The Baseball Bunch.
The Baseball Bunch.